Evening, traders. Good evening, Philippines. Today is the last day of the week. It's Friday, October 23rd. And before I go on, and again, as usual, I don't have my disclaimer here. Hold on, let me go check if I can find it, as usual. Okay, here we are. So before we begin, here is the usual disclaimer. Any comments made during this live webinar should not be taken as an order to enter trades, nor should it be considered as trading advice. This live webinar is strictly for educational purposes only, to illustrate how I trade the system that I teach my students, which is the legacy setups. And any past performance of the legacy setups is not indicative of future results. I must also emphasize that I'm neither a licensed nor professional trading advisor. And again, this live webinar is strictly for educational purposes only, and I do not provide any trading signals and so forth. So with that said, let's get to the chase here with the chart. In fact, I think we're moving here right now. I predicted it would hit this level around here. See this area right here that would start reversing, but I think it's not gonna reverse. I think it's more like correcting and bounce off this and continue going up. As you see now, we're going on more of an uptrend. That's the trend right now for today. It's from last night, from yesterday. Which, what time was this? This was actually hold on. You can find my thing here. Hold on. Here we are. So this was actually right here. So that's around, can't get my cross here. Around 8 o'clock in the Eastern time, overnight session. So from that point on, it started beginning to go up. And you can see here, if I draw this trend line, it's more of an angle going up this way than we sped up more in terms of our ascent. It sped up and now we're basically going up like this, right? So that's where we are currently. Our overall momentum now is still down, but now we're looking for possible reversal. If it gets to point A here, this is what we consider point A, then now that'd be a complete reversal back to the upside. If it hits this, which is basically, I had it on my other thing here. This, so basically this is A and this is your B, right? So if it hits this area somewhere here, or your B area right here, that's basically most likely we'll start going up. So this B area, let me draw a line here if it hits there. Let me draw a ray here, because that's basically your B. Oops. Let me see here. Horizontal line right here. So let me make this different in terms of color, so I can distinguish it, that is the line right there. So that's our B. If that basically hits that area and surpasses that, we're most likely eventually going back up, trying to go over here. So we'll see. Right now we're in the pullback zone, this red area, the three lowered lines can either reverse back in one of these areas. But here is the trend line going up. We'll see it's coming down to the trend line and also to the moving average. So there's a high probability it's going to bounce off and continue going up. Let me see here. Other than that, let's look at the micro view, or the more zoomed in view. So this is what we're looking at right now. The market's about to open, or in fact already opened. There it is. Get all this out. This is from earlier, the overnight session I traded. I got $600. I'm pretty much done for the day. I'll see what I can do with this. I'm going to decide if I'm going to trade my demo, because I don't want to risk anything in that one and get back, unless I see a good high probability setup. So let me see here. There we are. So here we are. We're coming down. Here's the VWAP. We'll see if it's going to bounce off this Wii U app or will it continue. So in terms of fibs, we're looking at right down here, and we see more of a return there. We're going back down to the retracement zone down here, the pullback zone. We can see if it's going to continue going up because it never really hit the target up here. So most likely it's going back down to the pullback zone and continue going up. So we'll see whether that's going to happen. But you can see here, see what happens. Okay, so right now our overall, as you can see here, our overall momentum here is basically to the upside. We are just going back down here, probably see what happens here. It's going to bounce off, and again, that's almost like the VWAP. If you look at more into this one, that's more like the VWAP. Here's the VWAP, and that's where we're at. So we'll see if it's going to bounce off here and continue going up. Okay. Again, I'm trading three contracts. I'll decide if I'm going to trade demo, because right now I'm already up 600 with that one trade right here. I made 600. So I'll put this on mute. No, I'll just leave it on, but we'll see what happens, okay? Set this up. Okay, we got there. Okay. So you can see now it's forming some type of support right now. So we'll wait and see what happens here. It's approaching the, and most likely if it does get down here, it's probably going to be here where it's going to reverse. This is your minus one deviation. It already hit the plus two deviation, so most likely it's going to get down here to minus one and then continue going back up. Again, this is usually your pullback zone, your Fibonacci level or your Fibonacci points. So my students will be asking why I didn't take this trade. That's a very good V2. I just don't want to be anywhere close to this VWAP because you don't know if it's going to continue going, bounce off. So right now we went right through it. So maybe we're aiming for this down here. So we'll see if it's going to come back up there and evaluate what's going to happen there. I took a super aggressive entry here. Not really your optimum entry. Possibility I'm gonna get stopped out here. I didn't get the whole full profit, and again, I was expecting to get down here, didn't really get down there, so still made money. Let me see here. Yeah, I'm now up 787.50, so maybe I made 187 there, right? So we can see another trade. Again, my goal for the morning session is between 300 to 600, another additional 300 to 600. So I do my thing here. So this is from this morning or overnight session. And see, I'm up 787.50. So basically the morning session, I've made 100, what I showed there, 180, what is it? 187.50. So we can do one more trade. See, now it's going to go down. Yeah, I don't want to. We'll see what happens during the fill line, because right now I'm thinking it's going to. The fill line will provide support. As you can see by the MACD, it's already going up. So we'll see what happens there. Again, we're the VWAP here. Since we're below the VWAP, let's look at the other. Let me see here. This is right here. This is more, I like this better, since the, what we call the RTH, or what we call the regular trading hours. So you can see we're below both the VWAPs. So basically our bias is down, okay? That's where our bias is. So that might be another, she's gonna overrun it. If not, see, 52.
Order submitted.
Try it again. Oops.
Order filled. Since
we have two VWAPs there, that's strong. Supposedly, it's going to be strong support or resistance, I mean. So we'll see if that's going to hold there. If it breaks here, then, you know, we're probably going to go back up. So we'll see. It's going to test this. It's going to test this VWAP. In there. It tested it. It's going to probably break through. And did so. That's what I said. So here we are going back up.
Order submitted.
Fibs here. Okay. Remember, this is our retrace zone. So that's what it was. So let's see if I can get this back right here. Maybe I'm not going to adjust my thing there. So we're looking this to go maybe up to here. That's one. Let's say wrong right here. Maybe 5, 59.75, right there. I was in mute. So yeah, so now we're going, it looks like it just touched this right here and never really got past the minus one deviation. Again, this looks like it's going to come back down. It's going to test that. I just don't want to risk it anymore. We're in this conundrum right here where it's just, I don't know what it's going to do. So there's really no, it's almost like a chop again. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to sit this out just like yesterday. And we'll wait and see where they want to take this. If we're looking at this, it looks like they're trying to take it down. As you can see right here, see, we hit the high for the day, so that's what they're trying to do. Let's see, they're going to come back down here at least. So let me see here. We have there on 54, 51, 50.
Order submitted.
Do it right there. Just look at this. This is more of a high probability. We're below both VWAPs as usual, right? We just want to make sure that we have the right momentum going down right now. Momentum is not really that strong to the downside. It's trying to pick up momentum, but we'll see. Again, we're below the two VWAPs, which is good. But the momentum, according to the MACD, is not that strong to the downside. So let me just chop here for a bit, or might, what do we call, grind for a bit before it picks up momentum to the downside. I'm getting a lot of erratic movements sometimes, and like this one, we'll see what happens here. I'm not gonna wind my stop. I don't wanna risk anymore, but like I said, I feel comfortable about this entry. We'll just see if the market will behave this structure. We'll basically adhere to the market structure. If not, then, you know, trading is about believing in your system. You, if you have a strategy, you have to believe in it. You can't just bail on it and have complete confidence in your system. If you trade it by the rules, according to the rules. And if you do all that according to the rules and you still lose, then it's, like I said, high probability entries are just that. They're high probability, but doesn't guarantee it's 100% going to win. Usually high probability is anywhere from 75% on up. So that 25% you will lose. So doesn't guarantee that you're gonna win. That's what I do clarify about high probability. You have a bigger probability of winning, but doesn't guarantee that you'll win 100%. Again, we really don't have really momentum going down right now. It's basically chop. So I'm gonna get chopped out here again as usual. And if that happens, we'll see. Take what the market's going to give me. So that's about it, right? You don't really dictate to the market how much you want to make. It's whatever it's going to give you. Thank you. Oops. I said that's 312. My net, I keep muting myself. My net right now is 219.26. So one more trade would put me well over 500 again. So we'll do that. We can get a high probability entry here. Again, if we're looking at this. What's going on here? Yeah, it's going to eventually go down. We hit the high point here. And remember this area I was telling you, it was close. So now it's going down. Now it may get down to here, back to the pullback area. So I may just have to see. Take that trade. So deciphering this, we're in the confluence. This is basically a retrace going back up. We'll see what happens if it obeys that, or are we going down?
Submitted.
And the reason I'm not taking this buy trade is because of this VWAP. Two of the VWAPs, they're both right there. So that's really strong resistance. I want to see this break and then come back down and then basically break it, break above it, and then pull back to it, and then that would be a good trade. But right now, my bias is still down because of the VWAP. As you can see, this price is really not going past this VWAP. That's why it's a very strong resistance. It breached it here, but we'll see if it's going to continue going up. It's very slow. That's why I didn't want to take that buy. And at some time, what very erratic moves. Okay, I'm at 5, 12, 50. I think we already hit our target. My net is 405. So I call it, I'll call it a day. I hit our profit target, even though on I started off with 600. Basically lost a few, maybe $100 I lost in there. See, look at this. Now it's coming back down. It basically just teased it up there, came back down. We'll see if that's going to continue going down here. Very erratic. So, again, hit my goal, 512.50, and that is around 400, 460, I think. No, 405. Let me see if this is gonna continue going down. I just wanna make sure. Well, we're well below this thing. I could have taken one right here, but I hate that when they have these erratic movements like this. You don't know where they're gonna take it. See, like there, look at this. And try to test, it's gonna try to test this view app again. This to maybe two contracts, so I don't have a, or even one contract, just to get me over. Let's see here, two. Let me show what I have here. Nope, that's not it. So this confluence of the two fibs is that's why it's choppy. We have the confluence of the fibs, the both the retrace levels of both going up and going down, right? In they're basically in confluence right now. There it is. We'll see if this can continue.
Submitted. canceled.
I don't like the looks of this. I might call it a day because, see, there it is, the thing. Just basically having erratic movements going up and down here. I don't want to be dealing with that. Snowball price action. That's what it is. So, I should be done for the day for sure now. Made more what I came with. 712.50 gross. And my net is 597. So I'm definitely done. So there is a lesson to be learned. Once you're up 600, just leave it at that. And if you want to trade, just cut back on your contracts, so maybe one contract. So if you lose that one contract, at least you can quit and you're still up, right? Lesson learned. I'm just teaching you guys, but I, you know, sometimes overconfidence can kill you. So with that said, I am done for the day. Again, met my goal right there, and I will enjoy your weekend today. Got today's Friday. Enjoy your weekend. I'll talk to you guys again on Monday. Enjoy, stay safe, and most of all, God bless. Talk to you guys on Monday. Bye-bye.